Hello everyone, welcome to TutorialsPoint. In this video, we will be learning about average atomic mass. It is known that isotopes are the atoms of same element with same atomic number but different mass number. Now, chlorine exists in two isotopic forms, that is chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. Now, both these isotopes of chlorine have the same atomic number, that is 17, because they have equal number of protons. Chlorine 35 has 17 protons and also chlorine 37 has 17 protons. But there is a difference in the number of neutrons in both the cases. That is, chlorine 35 has 18 neutrons, whereas chlorine 37 has 20 neutrons, which makes the difference between these two isotopes. Now, these two isotopes of chlorine exist in nature in the ratio 3:1. It means that chlorine 35 makes 75% of the total chlorine atoms that is available in this world, and the rest of the 25% is made by chlorine 37. Now, these two isotopes of chlorine exist in nature as a mixture. Now, here a question arises that what should we take as the atomic mass of chlorine? That is, whether we should take it as 35 or 37? The answer is none of these. In fact, we take the average of both the masses, and that is what we call as the average atomic mass. Now, how do we take the average of these two masses? Usually, what we do is we add the two numbers and divide it by 2. But this method of finding an average is totally wrong in this case. So what we should do? We have to find the contributions of both the chlorine atoms and then add them up, which gives us the average atomic mass. So the contribution of chlorine 35 is 75% of 35U. Here U denotes the unit of atomic mass, which is called the unified mass. Now, the contribution of chlorine 37 here is 25% of 37. And we simply need to add these two contributions to get the answer. So, this equals 75 by 100 multiplied by 35 plus 25 by 100 multiplied by 37, which ultimately yields the answer as 35.5U, which is the average mass or the average atomic mass of chlorine. Now, when an element has no isotopes, we can simply take its mass to be the sum of the number of neutrons and protons. But whenever an element has isotopes, we have to take the average atomic mass of all the isotopes and consider that as the mass of that element. Now, let us take another example of bromine. Now, bromine exists in two isotopic forms, that is bromine 79 and bromine 81. Now, these two isotopes are available in nature in this abundance, that is 49.7% of bromine atoms in this world is of bromine 79. And the rest of the 50.3 atoms of bromine in this world is of bromine 81. So now let us find the average atomic mass of bromine. The contribution of bromine 79 is 49.7% of 79, and the contribution of bromine 81 similarly is 50.3% of 81. Now we simply need to find their values and add them up to find what is called the average atomic mass of bromine. That is 49.7 by 100 multiplied by 79 plus 50.3 by 100 multiplied by 81, which ultimately yields us an answer of 80.006 U, which is the average atomic mass of bromine. So in this video, all we have learned is how to find the average atomic mass of all the isotopes of a particular element. So I hope you had fun learning this lesson. Thank you.